And while the president visited the Gulf today, NewsHour correspondent Tom Bearden was talking with local residents and business people about their plight and the government's response so far. Tom filed this report from the town of Barataria, Louisiana.
This is probably the last boatload of shrimp that will come out of Barataria Bay for the foreseeable future. Oil invaded the bay last weekend and started drifting northward. Officials closed the last stretch of the fishing ground this morning. Donovan Hinton is a charter boat deckhand. He says the charter fishing season is pretty much ruined.
Probably 30 trips were canceled this morning.
Some of the people we talked to were pleased that President Obama was visiting the Gulf today. But Hinton wonders if the president knows what people here are really facing.
We could offer him some boat rides and show him some things out there, rather than a lot better than what you can see in an airplane, a helicopter. I know he likes to fly a lot, but he needs to take some time and go in a boat with some local boys and really see what's going on out there.
Charter Captain Jim Maynard doesn't think shutting down exploratory drilling in the Gulf is the answer.
Oh, I think it's crazy. I think the rigs out there can be safe, but they need somebody to watch them, you know? And you need this oil. It's all, you know, supports this country. If you start doing that, then you're going to shut down jobs on these rigs, you know? I can't say anything against the people that are out there. I mean, they're out there trying to make a living just like we are. So why not, you know, let it go, but put more restraints on them?
Michael Roberts and Tracy Kuhn's fishing boat is tied up at the dock behind their house, and it isn't going anywhere anytime soon. Michael is filling his time transporting materials for a fishing camp renovation project. He signed up with BP to work on the cleanup, but the company's never called. The spill dominates conversation with neighbors like David Fricke, who is semi-retired. Like everybody else, he's angry.
People like me,
that's right,
that came down here and bought this place for a specific reason,
right,
is to change my lifestyle, have something that I look forward to all my life, and now they've destroyed it because I can't go fishing where I want to.
That's right.
And I'm going to sue them.
We asked Roberts and Kuhn's what they'd like to say to the president.
Stop acting like you work for BP Oil. The response has been pitiful. I mean, I've been to meetings with the Coast Guard. Everybody's downplaying the oil spill. I've been at 3 meetings where the Coast Guard told me that it's just a sheen on the water. Well, a sheen on the water violates the Clean Water Act of the United States. So how come when BP puts a sheen on the water, it's okay? It's no big deal. It's just a sheen on the water. I was told that by a commander in the Coast Guard at a meeting in Dulac. So that commander answers to an admiral. That admiral answers further up, and that the buck stops at President Obama. Get rein in your federal agencies and have these people start doing their jobs down here in South Louisiana. We are being destroyed by this oil spill.
Now, the difference between the federal response after the storms, after Katrina, and now is that President Obama has sent agency people down to the community level, and they've held meetings and they've had listening sessions, and you can see them taking notes. The problem is they're taking listening, but then there's no response. It's like they're protecting BP rather than the citizens, and their job is to protect us.
It's not just the fishermen in Louisiana who are upset about all this. People in 3 other states are also affected. Over in Picayune, Mississippi, about an hour to the east, Tony Carbone is also wondering what the future holds.
Yes, I'm very scared, very scared. This is our life. Seafood has been our life. We're in our 3rd generation. That's what we were born doing. I think I have fraction salt water in my blood. And people ask me why I won't leave the South, because I tell them my gills will dry up.
Carbone's dockside restaurant is all about seafood. Shrimp on ice. Live crawfish carefully sorted. And oysters in the deep fryer. But no Louisiana blue crab. Like everybody else around here, Carbone's worried about whether he'll be able to buy enough seafood to stay in business. And he worries that Louisiana once again won't get the attention he thinks it deserves.
We're just such a big, powerful nation, and Louisiana once again, I guess maybe should be feeling like a third world country, which I hate to say that, but, you know, we're slower to respond, it seems like, you know, in South Louisiana than we respond to other areas around the world.
Carbone's disappointed with the federal response to the disaster, and he'd really like President Obama to provide more frequent updates to the people in the coastal states.
He is making a second visit. We welcome him. We're certainly glad to see him again. It would have been nice, and we're glad he came on the onset of it. That was great. I think the public would have felt a little more comfortable and would have liked to have seen him really on a daily basis, giving us a briefing on what's going on behind the scenes. He's talking today about what has been done, but it sure would have been nice to hear him, see him, come say what is being done on a daily basis.
George Lodz also needs some encouragement. He has a seafood wholesale business and a huge freezer full of product. A lot of his customers started stocking up when the oil started pouring out of the seafloor more than a month ago, but business has dropped off dramatically.
In the beginning, everybody was rushing to scoop up whatever they could do to supply, put in their freezers, and buy ahead in case it kept on. Now business has fell off the last couple of weeks because just as many people that I feel that were running out to buy and stock their freezers and hurry up before prices went up. Some people, I think the general public, is backing off and saying, wait a minute, I don't want to eat this.
He wants people's faith in seafood restored, and he thinks the oil companies have to make things right by capping the well.
My personal opinion, I think they're doing what they're capable of doing. They probably could do a little bit more, but BP and Transocean, that was their rig, that was their business, just like this is my business. If something happens here, I'm responsible for it. The government can only do so much. They didn't drill the well, they can't stop it. That's not their expertise.
He doesn't blame the president or the federal government for the explosion or the spill.
I think it's his responsibility to see that BP and that we do everything we can to clean up this mess. But the president didn't make the oil well blow. The government really doesn't know what to do. The people that are in the oil field business know what to do, and they could tell the government, hey, we need this and we need that, but the government's not in the shrimping business either. They can't tell the shrimpers how to go catch shrimp. I don't think they can tell BP how to clean it up because that's not government's job.
In his younger days, Lodz was a fisherman. He plans to volunteer to work on a shrimp boat for free, if he can find one still operating, because he wants to experience that one more time in case the oil disaster prevents him from ever shrimping again.